On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Welcome to P-Kids Preschool Online. I'm Anaya.
And I'm Bella.
Friends, we have been learning all about saying no to sin like Jesus.
That's right, Anaya. Jesus was the best teacher, and he showed us how to say no to sin. Jesus kept his heart clean and pure so that he could be a good teacher to everyone around him.
Friends, what do you think this is? That's right, it's a microphone.
We can use a microphone to make our voice really loud.
Bella, this microphone helps me remember to use my voice to say no to sins. Let's all play a game with our microphones.
For the game, we'll say sin and you say no into your microphone with us. Are you ready?
Great, should we throw a fit?
No.
Should we say mean words?
No.
Should we disobey our leaders?
No.
How about, should we make a mess and leave it?
No.
Wow, great job saying no to sin.
Now let's go on an adventure with Emily and Shine and find out more about keeping our hearts clean like Jesus.
Friends, I'm happy to see you. I'm going on a Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you want to go with me. Woohoo! Who is it? Come in.
Lee! Hiya, Emily. Hiya, friends.
Shine, what should we find out on our Bible adventure?
Let's find the answer to the question, what do you say to sins?
Sins? You mean wrong choices? I do want to know what I should say when I think I want to sin.
Well, I know which picture passes will help you find the answer.
Friends, put on your adventure bags. Now we can be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. You wash with it to get nice and clean.
Friends, which one is it? You're right! It is the soap! Catch the soap in your adventure bag! Shine, what's next?
This picture pass is icky and sticky. It makes you get all dirty.
Ew! Friends, which one is it? You're right! It is the mud! Catch the mud, the icky, sticky mud, in your adventure bag.
Now there's only one picture pass left, but it's a fun one.
What is it?
You yell into it to make your voice really loud.
Friends, which one do you think it is? You are great guessers. It is the megaphone. Catch the megaphone in your adventure bag. Friends, count with me.
One, two, three.
They're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bag together.
Hmm.
Now it's time to fly!
Whoa!
Whoa! Shine, picking those picture passes was fun, but talking about sin and wrong choices isn't.
You're right. Sin is always bad.
Well, how do I find the answer to the question? What do you say to sins?
When I need help finding answers, I look in the Bible.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
A test in the desert. Hey, that story's from the book of Matthew in the Bible.
Let's hope it shows us what we should say to sins. Let's find out.
God's Spirit led Jesus into the desert. He had nothing to eat for 40 days and nights. After that, Jesus was very hungry. Knowing that Jesus was hungry, the devil tempted him. He pointed to a rock and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these rocks to become bread." Jesus answered the devil using God's words from the Bible.
"It's not just bread that keeps people alive," he said. "Their lives also depend on what God says."
Next, the devil took Jesus to the top of the temple. "If you are the Son of God, jump off. The scriptures say that God's angels will rescue you." So Jesus used God's word to give his second answer. "Do not put the Lord your God to the test," he said, quoting again from the Bible. Finally, the devil took Jesus to a mountain and showed him all the world's kingdoms and wealth. "This can be yours," he said, "if you bow down and worship me."
"Go away, Satan," Jesus commanded. Then he quoted God's word one more time. "For it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only."
As soon as Jesus said it, the devil left him. Then angels came and cared for him. Jesus had faced temptation and hadn't sinned, not even once.
Rizzlin' razzles! The devil wanted Jesus to sin!
But Jesus was God's son, so he always said no to sins.
I think I know the answer now. Shine, ask me the question.
What do you say to sins?
I say no to sins.
Wait, that's the answer. I bet Guy, the Bible guy, knows a Bible verse about that.
Oh, I bet you're right. See ya, Shine.
See ya, Emily.
Friends, let's go! Hi, Guy!
Hey, Emily!
We just learned that Jesus always said no to sins.
Oh, that's right. He never made a wrong choice because he's God's son. He stayed pure.
Pure? What's that mean?
Pure means clean. Jesus' heart stayed clean from sin.
Jesus didn't even have one wrong choice in his heart?
He sure didn't. Do you have a picture pass about that?
I think I do! Friends, which picture pass do you wash with to get nice and clean? Friends, you got it! It is the soap! We wash with soap to get clean on the outside.
And Jesus is like super soap to wash you pure and clean on the inside. He takes sin and wrong choices right out of your heart.
How do I know if he's washed my heart to be pure and clean?
Have you asked Jesus to be your leader and your best friend?
You know I have.
Then he has washed you pure and clean on the inside. I know a Bible verse about that. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to say the verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Looks like you're all ready. Listen to this. Psalm 51:10. God, create a pure heart. Ba-bum, ba-bum. In me.
I like it. Friends, say it with me this time.
Okay, here we go. Psalm 51:10.
Psalm 51:10.
God, create a pure heart, ba-bum, ba-bum.
Create a pure heart, ba-bum, ba-bum.
In me.
In me.
Great job. Now let's try it all together.
Psalm 51:10. God, create a pure heart.
Ba-bum, ba-bum.
In me.
That's it. After God washes sin and wrong choices out of your heart, what do you say to sin?
I say no to sins, just like Jesus. Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily.
Come on.
Bye, friends.
Ooh. Clownette, what you doing?
Ooh la la, I am making a mud puddle. Ooh.
Whoa, watch it. You almost got my new tie all dirty.
Oh, sorry, Blinky. But this mud puddle is just so fun.
I do love playing in mud puddles.
Hiya, Blinky. Hiya, Claudette. What you doing?
I am having so much fun in this mud puddle.
Nice, super-de-duper want to play in it, too.
But he is wearing his new bow tie.
Yeah, my mom said I can't take it off, and I gotta keep it clean. I'll get in trouble if it's dirty.
Friends, should Blinky say yes or no to playing in the mud puddle?
Shine, our friend said I should say no, but I still really want to play in that mud puddle.
Jesus knows how hard it is to say no to sins, but he still made the right choice every time.
Do you think he'll help me make the right choice too?
Sure, Jesus wants you to live like him by saying no to every sin.
All right. I'm gonna pray. God, please help me to live like Jesus and say no to sins. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, Blinky, what are you gonna tell Claudette?
I'm gonna say no because I wanna obey my mommy. Claudette!
Well?
Thanks for inviting me to play. But if I disobey my mom, that's a sin. I'm saying no to sins. And keeping my bow tie clean.
It's all right, Blinky. Perhaps next time, when you aren't wearing your bow tie?
Yeah. Next time, we'll make the biggest mud puddle ever. Keeping my tie clean. Keeping my tie so clean. I can obey my mom.
Hi, friends. Say the Bible verse with me. Psalm 51:10. God, create a pure heart. Boom, 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 boom. In me. Yowza palowza! That Bible verse really gets me thinking about the word Guy the Bible Guy taught us. Pure. Soap washes us pure and clean on the outside, just like Jesus washes us pure and clean on the inside. And Jesus helps us say no to sins so we can stay pure. Now that is music to my ears. Speaking of music, that must be Mr. Music. Come on, let's go. Hi, Mr. Music.
Well, hi, Emily. What's your Bible adventure about this time?
We're trying to find the answer to the question, what do you say to sins?
I say no to sins.
That's it. But why are sins bad?
sins and wrong choices are icky and sticky. They make your heart all dirty. God can't live inside a heart like that.
Dirty? Icky and sticky? I think I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass is icky and sticky and makes you all dirty? Friends, you're great guessers. It is the mud.
Mud is icky and sticky, like sin.
I don't want my heart to be dirty. I want my heart to be pure and clean and have God live inside of me.
I know a song that'll help. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing it with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Great. In this song, we get to practice saying no to sins. You ready? Here we go. Should we lie?
No.
Should we fight?
No.
Should we say mean words?
No.
I say no to sins. Should we disobey?
No.
Should we hit?
No.
Should we throw a fit?
No.
I say no. I say no to sins.
That's it. Now let's do the whole song. I don't want to be icky.
Oh, no.
Or sticky like sins.
Uh-uh.
I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives.
I don't want to be icky. Or sticky like sins. I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives.
Should we lie?
No.
Should we fight?
No.
Should we say mean words?
No.
I say no to sins.
Should we disobey?
No.
Should we hit?
No.
Should we throw a fit?
No.
I say no. I say no to sins.
Yeah. Let's do it again. I don't want to be icky.
Oh, no.
Or sticky like sins.
Huh?
I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives.
I don't want to be icky or sticky like sins. I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives.
Should we lie?
No.
Should we fight?
No.
Should we say mean words?
No.
I say no to sins.
Should we disobey?
No.
Should we hit?
No.
Should we throw a fit?
No.
I say no. I say no to sins. I say no to sins. I say no to sins. I say no to sins.
That was awesome. Now, stand to your feet to worship God with music, singing, and dancing.
Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours, I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. I am a child.
God, you are strong. You are mighty.
Emily, did you find the answer to the question?
Yep, yuppers! Ask us the question and we'll tell you the answer.
Okay, what do you say to sins?
I say no to sins.
Wee! Did you learn the verse too?
We did! Friends, say it with me. Psalm 51:10. God, create a pure heart. Boom, 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 boom. In me.
Wow, that Bible verse reminds me of the picture passes.
Oh, yeah. The soap makes us clean on the outside.
Just like Jesus washes us pure and clean on the inside when we ask him to take away our sins. What about that icky, sticky mud?
The mud shows us what sin is like. Sin makes your heart dirty.
Ew! God can't live in a heart full of sins and wrong choices.
Shine, nobody told us about the megaphone.
I use a megaphone to practice doing my favorite thing.
You do? What's your favorite thing?
Saying no to sins. You want to try it with me?
Yeah! Friends, I'll say a sin, and you say no with us! Here we go! Should you run away from your mom?
No!
Should you throw a fit?
No!
Should you take toys from your friends?
No!
Our friends are really great at saying no to sins.
Let's pray that we'll say no to sin every day, just like Jesus.
Okay, friends, bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, thank you for giving us Jesus to make our hearts pure and clean. Help us to say no to sins. In Jesus' name, amen. Tumbling Tomcats, it's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Wow, I love learning about Jesus saying no to sin. Friends, do you remember what a microphone reminds us to do? That's right, say no to sins.
Friends, we have some questions about the story. Are you ready?
Great. Where did Jesus go? Yes, the desert. Friends, rub your tummy like you're hungry.
What did Jesus say to sins? That's right, he said no. Friends, say no together.
No! Did Jesus listen to Satan? No, he did not. Friends, clap your hands to celebrate Jesus' good choices.
Did Satan leave when Jesus said, go away? Yes, yes, he did. Point at the picture of Satan and yell, go away.
Who came to take care of Jesus? That's right, God's angels. Pretend to be angels taking care of Jesus.
Wow, great job, friends. God's angels took care of Jesus. Who takes care of you? That's great. My family takes care of me too.
Friends, let's pray and thank God for helping us saying no to sin. Parents, ask your kids what else they'd like to pray about.
God, thank you for loving us and helping us say no to sin. Thank you for sending Jesus to help us know you better. Please keep us safe and healthy. In Jesus' name, amen.
That was so much fun. Don't forget to visit our potentialchurch.com/family website and download your Blinky activity sheet.
Thank you for spending this time with us. We had so much fun and hope to see you soon.
Bye.